Welcome to the video tutorial on using census data in Excel. I am Alexandra Barker, Data Dissemination Specialist with the Census Bureau. During this tutorial, you will learn about how to perform advanced analysis of census data using Excel. The vast majority of time, Excel as it is provides you with what you need to access, combine, query, transform, visualize, and otherwise play with your census data using the visualizations, formulas, and functions. There are, however, advanced tools for statistical analysis that you can turn on as add-ins. You do not need to download anything, you just need to turn it on. Doing so will give you tools for regression testing, histograms, ANOVA correlation and covariance, exponential smoothing, F-test, Z-test, and T-tests, four-year analysis, moving averages, rank and percentile summaries, sampling in a more sophisticated random number generator than the standard function. But going through all of these statistical functions and methods is beyond the scope of this training, so I will just give you a basic idea of how it can be used with a few examples. We'll enable the add-on and do some basic analysis on an income table downloaded from the American Fact Finder. So let's start. The table that you see right now, I downloaded through the Community Facts option in American Fact Finder. It's a table that compares the median household income by state. Once it's downloaded in Excel, all I have to remember is to always format as table. So when you click here, you can always format as table, and you'll be able to unlock great features in Excel. To enable now the add-in, we're going to click on File, then we're going to go to Options and choose Add-ins. If you do not see the Analysis Toolpack, you can always go to Manage Add-ins and click Go. And then you can check the Analysis Toolpack and OK. So now, when you click in Data, you'll see that's now available for you. We will first look at descriptive statistics, which describe the main features of a dataset. They are the basic statistics you would generally want to start with, even if you are doing more sophisticated analysis of data. Descriptive statistics provide, for example, information about the central tendency, variability, and overall shape of your data in just a few clicks. First, select your income table. Next, from the Data tab, click Data Analysis. Select Descriptive Statistics and click OK. You need to select an input range, and for this example, we want it to be all the income from the column median household income. Make sure it's grouped by column. For your output options, you want it to be a new worksheet, and I'm naming it Descriptive Stats. Important to check Summary Statistics. After you do this, click OK. You will now have a new tab called Descriptive Stats. Again, these are useful for your first glance at the data to initiate your statistical analysis. Now, if you want to tell the number of occurrences of a value or a range in a dataset, your best option is to use the histogram chart. You may recall from school that sometimes letter grades were distributed in odd boundaries. Chances are good that your teacher used a histogram to determine those letter grade boundaries and the number of scores that fell in the range. In this case, we are going to look at how the median income data is distributed. We'll create a column of beans where we want the data to fit. So somewhere in this spreadsheet, we need to enter in separate rows on a column the bean numbers. So let's do that. Let's go back to the income table and create a bean. And our ranges will be 40,000, 50,000, 60,000, and my last one will be 70,000. I'm just making up these ranges, just for this example. Now let's go back to the Data tab and click on the Data Analysis tool. We're going to choose the histogram here in the bottom and then click OK. Let's select income data for the input range. Now let's select our beam range. Now I have to select some empty space on the spreadsheet for the output range. And let's click the chart output box right here on the bottom. Don't forget this option and just click OK. So what you see now is a histogram that we just created using the data analysis tool. So now let's move on to sampling. The data analysis tool makes it super simple to get samples from a population. Although this is a very small amount of data within 51 data points, you can imagine if you are doing research on a data set with hundreds, thousands, tens of thousands of data points. Getting a random sample from such a large data set, it's not that easy. So even though this is a trivial example, it is good to know how it is done. So let's go to the data analysis tool and let's choose sampling and click OK. Our input range, it's just going to be the income again. I want a random sample, so let's indicate the number of samples, and for that will be 5. And then you have to select an output range. So I need 5 spaces for my output, then I need to select 5 different cells. Then click OK. Now you have your sample with no complex formula, no macros, and no repetitive operations required. This concludes our overview on how to conduct advanced analysis of census data in Excel. For more video tutorials, visit census.gov and subscribe to our YouTube channel. And don't forget to follow us on social media. Thank you!